CataractCoach.com. Cataract quiz. How do you insert an IOL with a capsular tear? You have an anterior capsular rim tear, and you don't want it to extend to the posterior capsule. So here, after all the cortex has been removed from the eye, don't deflate the eye. Go in with the second hand, the left hand, injecting the cohesive viscoelastic, and then come out of the eye with the IA probe. So we keep the eye inflated. Don't overinflate it. Here comes the IOL, a single piece of acrylic lens. We're going to place it in the capsular bag. And the key here is to be very gentle in its placement. Delivering it here, make sure the lens is loaded into the injector correctly. This looks good. And then get it into position and don't cause any stress to the capsule. So very gently here, get the haptics to open up. You can rotate it as well if you want to get the haptics away from that one area. Now, this single-piece lens, the haptics don't exert a very strong force out to the capsular equator. They don't. They're very gentle. So, therefore, you can place it kind of any direction you want. The classic teaching for a three-piece lens, if you're putting it in the bag like this, those are larger haptics, bigger diameter, more spring force to them, that you don't want them to be in a position where it'll cause the anterior capsular tear to run to the equator and then to the posterior capsule. But in a single piece of acrylic lens, I think you're okay. Now notice, hydration of the incision, sealing the incisions while the eye is still full of viscoelastic. Why is that? And that's so that when you go in the eye here and we remove the viscoelastic and come out of the eye, the incision is sealed and it's not going to allow the anterior chamber to collapse. So here we can see the lens in good position, removing viscoelastic. Again, with a single piece acrylic lens, you can have the haptics in any orientation you want. My advice is the less IOL manipulation, the better. Leave things be. This patient will have a beautiful visual outcome. No untoward effects from this anterior capsular tear out. But if you allow that tear out to go to the equator and then the posterior capsule, then we're going to be in a host of trouble. So we want to avoid that. So nice and gently removing viscoelastic from the eye. Notice we did not go behind the IOL optic to try and remove viscoelastic. That's maybe too much stress. Leave it be. Don't have to sweat it. Before you come out with the eye probe, inject balanced salt solution with the other hand. AC stays formed. Don't let the anterior chamber collapse or shallow. Now hydrating the incisions even more, getting the pressure where you want it. That lens position looks great, and this patient's going to have a beautiful outcome. A little extra hydration of the main incision. If you have any doubts, do what we're doing here. Place the suture. Very easy to place a suture. Doesn't require that much effort. Easy to do on the OR table, and ensures that this incision is not going to leak. What we don't want to happen is if the incision does leak, that may cause shallowing in the anterior chamber, may cause some instability, it may cause that capsular rip to go posterior, dislocated lens. We want to avoid all that. Beautiful case. That's how you manage this. Check out cataractcoach.com. We have a whole series of cataract quizzes. Click on the link there for all the videos by category. Click on cataract quiz. You'll learn a lot.